Hey. I think I'm very excited to see what the audience is like perception of these characters are for this season, because they already have like a firm decision on like we like these characters and we don't like those characters. And I think we like try to flip that upside down for this season. So it's going to be very interesting to see like what they think of the Queen or August or Wilhelm or Simon, you know.
Also, I'm excited to see what they think about the actions and the I lost the word. The actions, the character's actions and oh my God, Val, how do you say that? I forgot it completely.
Choices.
Choices, yeah, maybe, yeah, and what they do basically. Well, I want to start saying that Simon is a young teenager, and something that is really beautiful to see is that even the perfect, cute, well-raised Simon can also do mistakes and can also, make decisions that are really bad, and that is what is beautiful about this series, is that you get to see young adults or teenagers doing all of these things, but you at the same time you kind of like feel for them because you know their story, you know where they come from, and you know why they do these things. And so I feel like if I would know Simon, I would be like mad, but at the same time love him, because you know what I mean? It's a complicated situation. Yeah.
Yeah. Ooh, good question. Maybe, but I think it's important to note that Wilhelm is also like he's very driven by his intuition and his impulsiveness. And I think he's always been. That's the reason like he headbutts a guy at the club in season one, I think that's a beautiful ability that he has, but it also puts him in different not so good situations. But if he had a support network, maybe he'd be able to like what would you say, like reflect on his future decisions with his friends, or with his family, if he had been able to do that. So yeah, I think it would have made a difference. Yeah, I think it's important to have a support network, obviously. Yeah. I think well, like I said, it's going to be interesting to see what the crowd thinks of the Queen, because it's her decision to put Wilhelm in touch with the psychologist, who is brilliant, by the way. And I think that changes a lot for Wilhelm, because once he's able to like find a structural support network, even if it's just one person, he starts to reflect in a different manner, and he starts to, because he grows a lot very fast during the season. I think there's a few turning points where he actually is able to reflect on both perspectives, both the royal court and his love for Simon. And I think him being able to take mature decisions based off of those two perspectives is very mature, and he wouldn't have gotten to that place hadn't it been for him actually talking to a psychologist. I think one of the major like low points for Wilhelm is after what episode is that? It's that point. What episode could it be? He's talking to, it's one when he's talking to Felice about their experience together, and he's talking about Simon, and he comes to a decision where he's like, I gotta let him go. I think that's a very, very low moment. But also, I mean, where we see him at the beginning of this season is a very dark place, and a very lonely place. Yeah, one of those, I think.
I feel like I have a hard time of finding the scene where Simon actually is the saddest, because I feel like he's sad, but in a different way. Simon kind of like runs away from his sadness in a toxic way. Like he doesn't face the sadness and the truth about what he's actually going through. He runs away to the other guy to like run away from the feelings, to try to, you know, push everything away. And I don't know.
What about the music room scene? Isn't that one?
Which one?
It's in episode 5. Yeah, you know.
Oh, Wilhelm, yeah, when he finds out about... No, you know what? I know exactly when Simon is is on episode 6, I think. After shooting scene,
yeah,
all of us 5, and Sara says that it was her that, you know, have been in love with him for a long time, and she said that to August, all of that. When Simon finds out that his sister is doing that against him,
brilliant question. I think the what Wilhelm loves most about Simon is Simon's transparency. I think that's very fresh for Wilhelm, because he's been raised in a what would you say? He's been raised under like a culture where you're not that transparent and you keep secrets to protect certain people. But once he meets Simon, he realizes that Simon is very transparent with who he is, what he likes and whatnot. And obviously that changes for Simon as well during the course of the story. But I think that's Simon. Oh, Wilhelm still sees that in Simon, and I think that's what he loves the most about him.
Maybe in like season 1. I don't know if this fits season 2 for some of the things that Simon says in season 2, but maybe that, you know, Simon feels like Wilhelm loves him for who he is, basically. Simon doesn't have to change for anything. Like, well, you know, this whole thing outside of their relationship is what is causing them to, you know, be a secret or whatever. But like, as two persons, two individuals, I feel like Wilhelm loves Simon for who he is. And maybe that is something really important for Simon, because he's not going to change. You know what I mean?
Thank you. That's beautiful. Wow. Nice. Yeah, perfect. Thank you. Take care. Bye.